Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. In this video, we will discuss conic section, in that degenerated conic section. Please refer the previous video section of a cone to understand this in a better way. So here, the degenerated conic section means, in this case, we have a double right circular cone. So if the plane intersects the double right circular cone at its vertex, then we get some figures, and those figures are known as degenerated conic section. See, in the last video, we have taken the double right circular cone, and we have seen that depending on the direction in which the plane intersects the cone, we can have different types of curves like circle, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola. Now, in this case, the plane intersects the cone but at its vertex. So, depending on that, we are going to study different figures. So, let us consider the first case. See, in the case of circle, if the plane intersects the cone parallel to the base, then we get a circle that we have discussed in the earlier video. Now here what we do is, we intersect the cone that is parallel to the base but at its vertex. See, in the last video we have done the plane position, we have kept the plane position like this way. But now we have to intersect the cone at its vertex. So that's why I will do the intersect operation like this way. Let us say that we have a plane over here and that plane intersects the cone at its vertex. Then if I represent this in a 2D form, we get the figure like this way. And here, if the plane intersects the cone at the vertex position, then we get a dot. We get only a dot. So, or a point we can say. So, a point is formed when the plane intersects the cone parallel to the base direction, that time we get a point. And the condition for this we can consider as, see here we have a beta angle and this beta angle is 90 degree. You can observe that. So if beta is equal to 90 degree, we get a point. Next, let us move this plane in this direction so that we have a plane like this way. So now I will move this plane like this way. Then you can observe that the point is same. This point is not going to change even though if you move the plane. So in that situation, beta angle is reduced now. This beta angle is less than 90 degree, but it is greater than alpha. That you can observe. Now also you get a figure and that figure is nothing but a point. So we get a degenerated conic section. That degenerated conic section is a point in this case, in which case, that is if beta is equal to 90 degree and if beta is less than 90 degree or if beta is greater than alpha. So we can say that when alpha less than beta, less than or equal to 90 degree, then the section is a point and the point is a degenerated case of circle and ellipse. See, we intersect the plane like this way and like this way, in which case? In the case of circle, we intersect the plane parallel to the base. In the case of ellipse, we intersect the plane like this way. So we can say that in both the cases we are going to get a point. So point is a degenerated case of circle and ellipse. Next, here the second case. See, now let us say that the plane, we have a plane and the plane intersect the cone like this way, in this direction. Now in this case, what happens here, we get a straight line. You can observe that you get a straight line. And not only that one, if you see the alpha and beta angle, see the angle created by the plane with the axis and the angle created by the generator with the axis, both are one and the same. Beta is equal to alpha here. So now when beta is equal to alpha, the plane contains a generator of the cone and the section is a straight line. You can observe that. See here, the plane cut the cone in this direction. That time, what happens? The plane contains the generator of the cone and we get a section, and that section is a straight line. So straight line is a degenerated case of parabola. That is because here the plane is parallel to the generator, and when plane is parallel to the generator, then in the previous video we get a section and that section is a parabola. Whereas now here, if you cut the plane at its vertex like this way, then in that case we get a straight line. So that is the degenerated case of parabola. Straight line is a degenerated case of parabola, and for this condition is beta is equal to alpha. Next, we will consider the third case. Let us say that the plane intersects the cone like this way. So in this case, see, the beta angle is completely zero, because the axis as well as the plane both are at the same location, same place. That means beta is equal to zero. Now what happens? What you get? Now in this case, you get a straight line. Then next, let us consider the another case. So now this plane, I will move little like this way in this direction, so that we get this case where here you can observe that beta is little more greater than zero, but it is less than alpha. In this case also, you get a straight line. So for beta is equal to zero and for beta less than alpha, we get straight line. So if you combine these two figures together in one figure, then you can see that here we get a two straight line, and these two straight lines are intersecting with each other. So we can say that when zero, that is when beta is equal to zero or beta is less than alpha, then the section is a pair of intersecting straight line. Next here, the second case, another case in this, let us say that now we have kept the plane in this direction. Now here you can observe that that is beta is less than alpha. That is the this case which we have discussed here, same case I am taking. Next, if I move the plane little down, now plane is here. Now if I move the plane little down, then you can observe that here beta is greater than zero for this. So we have here two cases. Beta greater than zero, we get a straight line. If beta is less than alpha, then also we get a straight line. So if I combine these two figures in one figure, then I get the straight line like this way. So two straight lines are formed and these two straight lines are intersecting with each other. So that is the case if beta is greater than zero and beta is less than alpha. So when zero less than beta less than alpha, the section is a pair of intersecting straight lines. That means here we can say that here if you combine this part, that is this part as well as this previous part, we get a final condition as zero less than or equal to beta less than alpha. This is the condition for the hyperbola. So the section is a pair of intersecting straight line. So we can say that the intersecting straight line is the degenerated case of hyperbola. So this is about the degenerated conic section, where here we get a point, then we get a straight line and a intersecting straight line. So point is a degenerated case of circle and ellipse. Then straight line is a degenerated case of parabola, and then intersecting straight line is a degenerated case of hyperbola. Thanks for watching.